Hello everyone, welcome back to the NABARD Grade A ARD question series, the 5-day question series, and it's day 9. If you haven't watched the previous videos, do watch the previous videos. They are both of ARD and ESI. These two are very important in the upcoming NABARD examination, so do prepare. Now before starting with the video, the NABARD Grade A and Grade B comprehensive courses are available. You can just find the link in the description box or you can visit the website www.anujindal.in. Apart from this, the coupon code is available. So these are just the gross amount and NABARD 20, NABARD 20 is the coupon code which you can use and avail the 20% discount on these courses. Before starting with the today's question, this is pH of alkaline soils is the previous is the question from the previous video for the day 8. First of all, if you haven't watched that video, watch that video as well. And in that video, I asked you about the pH of the alkaline soils. Most of the people are answering, I have seen the comments as well, most of the people are answering 7 as the answer. But I asked you to choose the most appropriate one, and this applies to the exam as well. So as per these options, as per the given options, the most appropriate option is above 8.5. So the pH of the alkaline soil, so 6 to 7 is actually considered as the neutral range and we cannot say it to be the alkaline soil. Therefore, the 5 to 6, 7, these kind of range is considered to be a little neutral. But if we are categorizing or generally asking the pH of alkaline soils, then the answer is greater than 8.5 as per these given options. It's not 7, remember this thing. Now let's start with the today's question. So food material moves through which of the following in plants? Very easy question. We all have studied about this in our schools. Now let's discuss each one of these. So first of all, endodermis. Now what is this endodermis? So in simple terms, if we need to explain this endodermis, so it's basically the line which separates the inner vascular tissue from the outer cortex. Now this is the kind of a separator. And it basically functions as a selective nutrient intake. So endodermis could not be the one which through which the food material passes. Next is the phloem. Now phloem is the one, or we can say that xylem and phloem. These two are the vascular tissues of the plants. Now these are the vascular tissues of the plant, and one is majorly responsible for the transportation of water and another is responsible for the transportation of food and the other nutrients. So xylem, when we are talking about, so xylem is responsible for transportation of water and to keep the plant hydrated. At the same time, when we are talking about the phloem, so it is responsible for the transportation of food materials and nutrients. Another basic difference between xylem and phloem is as the picture shows over here, phloem is bidirectional, that moving both up and downward. But xylem is unidirectional and it just moves upward. This is must to remember over as a difference between xylem and phloem. And coming back to the answer of this question, so food material moves through the phloem. So through the vascular tissue phloem, this food material passes throughout the plant. It's a very easy question. Let's look at the another question. So which of the following is not the breed of buffalo? Now, it's important to remember the major breeds of buffalo, sheep, goat. It's very important. And in terms of the poultry animals, the breeds are again important. And there was question in the previous examination in 2017 and 18 regarding the breeds of these animals. They are being covered under the animal husbandry. Now, before going to the answer of this question, let's look at these breeds of buffaloes. You can pause the video and take a screenshot of this picture, and it's very important to remember each and every important breed of buffalo. Now, the question arises why it should be remembered. Because these breeds of buffaloes have specific characteristics from which the question could be framed in the examination. So the first breed is Murrah breed, the very common breed, and it's famous for the milk production and it has 7% fat in its milk. Now next is the Badawari, and it contains the highest fat. So 13% fat is the highest fat production in the milk of the Badawari. So a question might come in the examination regarding the fat production of the breed of buffalo. Next is the Zafrabadi, which is available in Gujarat, and it is very famous for the built. So it is famously known as the mini elephant because of the heavy and the loose body. Next is Surti, which is found in Gujarat, and it is famous for the sickle shape horn. So the horn of this Surti buffalo is sickle shape. Therefore, it's famous for its unique characteristics of sickle shape horn. Mehsana, as it is mentioned over here, it's a cross breed between Surti and Murra. So Murra and Surti makes up to Mehsana. Another famous one is Neel Ravi, which is found in Punjab, and it is famous for, or it is known as, the famously known as wall eyes. Why? Because it has white eyes. So because of the white eyes characteristics, white eyes features, this Neel Ravi is known as wall eyes. Now these are very important. You can just take a screenshot and learn about these breeds of buffalo. And let's go back to the question, where the question is, which of the following is not the breed of buffalo? So as we discussed over here, Neel Ravi is the breed, Murra is the breed, Bhadwari is the breed, Black Bengal is not the breed of buffalo, Zafrabadi is the breed of buffalo. So Black Bengal is the breed for goat. Very important breed of goat. Why? Because it is famous for its excellent meat. So one of the famous breeds of goat is Black Bengal, and you need to remember the breeds of buffaloes as well. Next question is, which of the following is the protozoan disease of poultry? So rather than cramming the names of the poultry diseases, we can go with the common sense over here. So let's look at the first option. So fowl cholera and diarrhea. We know that these two are the bacterial disease, so can't be protozoan disease. Now we need to filter between these three. So Ranikhet and Marek's disease is viral disease and is caused due to virus. And the left one is the coccidiosis, is the protozoan disease of poultry. You need to remember about these diseases, because these are some of the famous diseases of poultry, and a question might come in the examination. Now a question for you is that there was this news where the Kadaknath meat, or known as the black meat, so the Kadaknath chicken actually got the GI tag. So you need to mention in the comment section below that from which state the Kadaknath meat got the geographical indication tag. You need to mention the state from which the Kadaknath meat has got the geographical indication tag. Moving on to the next question. So which of the following does not come under the category of draught animals? So this is very easy question. All you need to know about is what or which animals are known as draught animals. So basically, draught animals are those animals which are needed for carrying load. So very easy question, nothing much to discuss. So you will be telling me in the comment section below that which of the following animal does not come under the category of draught animals, or the animal which cannot be used for carrying load. So mention that in the comment section below, that which of these mentioned, camel, donkey, mule, dog and elephant, among these which of the animal cannot be categorized as draught animal. The next question is, yellow color of cow milk is due to which of the following? So there are various nutrients or enzymes given mentioned over here. You need to choose the enzyme due to the presence of which makes the cow milk yellow. So the answer of this question is carotene. So the cow milk contains the beta carotene. So what happens is, this pigment actually makes the yellow color, or it gives the yellow color to the milk. Whereas at the same time, the buffalo milk lacks the same. So therefore, there is no yellow color in the buffalo milk. Next is casein. So casein is basically the major component of milk, or it is the primary group of milk proteins. So we can say that the major component of milk is casein. Next is lactose. So as casein is the protein component, lactose is the carbohydrate component. And what about the riboflavin? So riboflavin actually gives the greenish color. So it is found in the whey of the, milk or whey milk, and it is somewhat greenish in color. So for this question, carotene is the answer for the yellow color of cow milk. So what you need to mention in the comment section that first of all, which state has given the geographical indication tag to the Kadaknath meat, and another question that you need to answer, which of the following does not come under the category of draught animals. So this is all for the NABARD day 9 video for the ARD. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel Anuj Jindal if you have learned anything, and do not forget to share these videos with the people who are preparing for the NABARD examination. Thank you so much for watching the video.